Welcome to the Sheraman Law Classes. Dear colleagues and friends, today our topic is related with how to present your case before the judge in the court. So first of all, I shall talk with you how to present your criminal case before the judge or the jury at the trial stage. So when you are putting your case before the judge, it is important that you should read out all the documents, all the statements and all the files available on the record. So you have to mention all these things before the judge. So whenever you are arguing a criminal case, this is important that you should read out the story of the prosecution or the story of the FIR. And this is also very important that you should mention the date in the FIR in which the occurrence took place. Similarly, you have also to mention the date in which the FIR or the prosecution story was registered against the accused persons. Then you have to write down to the judge, try to persuade the judge to note your points. You should raise the important points, especially the you have to write down the name of the complainant, the names of the accused persons. Similarly, the offense is labeled in the FIR. All these things you have to read out to the judge one by one. Similarly, the distance between the occurrence and the police station, this is also very important. And then convince the judge that how much time was consumed when the occurrence took place and the complainant reported to the police. This point is also very important. Then start out to read the relevant portion of the prosecution story or FIR, and do not go into detail. Read only the relevant portion in the relevant story. After reading that, you have to switch over to the site plan, because site plan is a very important document, and you have to make out all the contradictions, all the flaws made by the police or the prosecution. You have to read out that points one by one to the judge or judges. Similarly, when you are arguing your case, this is also important that you should read out all the important documents, especially in criminal cases, the postmortem report, if any, you have to read out the medical report, if any, you have to read out the forensics science laboratory report, if it's there, you have to read out that. Similarly, the opinion of any expert regarding the occurrence, regarding the case, you have to read out that reports as well. And after reading all these important documents, you should go to read out the statement of the witnesses and try to read out the important witnesses in the start. And if the judge is giving you permission, so then try to read out all the statements of the witnesses. Then chief examination, you have to mention all the points in chief examination, and especially when you are reading out the cross examination, so try to bring out the contradictions, the discrepancies, the look-nos which are there in your case, and you have pointed out already their points. So you have to read out one by one all the points to the judge and try to persuade the judge to write down your points. This is very important. Through this you can also catch the attention of the judge. Then after completing all this, you have to move towards the statement of the accused. Read out the statement of the accused, what he has stated in his defense. You have to read out, so that is called the defense story. So you have also put out the defense story and read that to the judge or jury, whatever may be the case. Then after reading all that, you have come to your case laws which you have already searched out, and try to assess the court through relevant case laws which are having similarity with your case. Suppose if there is motto is missing in your case, so then you have to present case laws regarding the missing of motio, that is of the case laws related with the High Court or Supreme Court, you have to mention all that laws. Then if you have in your case there is the missing of mens rea or actus reus, that points are not involved, so you have to also refer case laws regarding that. And when there are contradictions or lucnas or major and minor contradictions, so you have also mentioned the case laws regarding their judgments, that how the court passed their judgments, because their precedents and courts are follow the precedents and or criminal and civil litigations. When you are completing all these things, so then come to your arguments and read out the facts which you have raised out in your case, put that facts one by one to the judge and try to convince the judge through a very convincing story which is believable, and it you should read that in a very loud manner and very clear. There shall be clarity in your words, and not only the judge or judges to whom you are putting your arguments, not only they shall understand your point of view, but the other counsel sitting in the courtrooms or clients or other people who are sitting in the courtroom, they shall also understand what are your facts and what is your story. So you have to do all that thing in a very convincing way. Then your language is also very important. When you are arguing your case, you should speak in a very polite way. You should address to the judge with your titles, that is my lord, your honor, your lordship, your ladyship, and other titles which are there for the judges. You have to use that titles again and again and address the judge in a very polite way. When you want to bring the attention of a judge on a certain point, so you have to address the court in a very polite way. Then keep eye contact with the judge or the jury, and keep attention on your file as well. And when you are arguing your case, your mind shall be free at that time, because you are arguing the case, the points which you are raising are very important. And when you are raising any point, remember that each and every point is very important, and you have to try to note down all the points to the judge or jury if possible. After that, you should come to the conclusion. You should sum up your what you have argued in your case, make a brief summary of that, and then try to make your prayer before the judge. And when you are making your prayer, you have to be very polite, and don't behave in a such a way which is bad, which is not allowed in the court. So your behavior must be very decent, polite. And whenever the judge is making finding flaws in your case, or making questions on you by raising bad points in your case, so you have to listen the judge attentively. Similarly, when the other counsel, the opposite counsel, making interruption in your case or raising the bad points or flaws in your case, so do not take it serious. Don't be an eye, be polite, and try to remain silent unless the judge is not giving you permission to talk. So this was about how to present a criminal case in the court. Similarly, when you are presenting a civil case, so in civil case, plaintiff story and the defendant stories are involved, so both are important, and you have to argue in the defendant story, the plaintiff story. First you have to raise the plaintiff story, then the defendant story, then the contradictions which are there in both the stories. You have to read out that contradiction to the judge. basically the job of the council, the job of an advocate is to assess the court. So we have to assess the court in a proper way. Then after that you have to come to the points raised by the judge, means the issue which are framed by the judge. You have to read out all the issues and you have to tell to the judge that which burden of proof lies on which party. You have to raise that, and after this you come to the case laws and regarding your case and make your final arguments and make a frail at the end. But in all this time you have to be very polite. So this was about our case presentation at the trial stage. Now I shall switch towards the appellate stage, that how to present your case at the appellate forum. The appellate forum may be the district and session judge or maybe the high court. So when you are arguing your case at the appellate forum, you have to be very clear about your case and you have to read out the index. In appeal we have an index and you have to read out that index, and according to that index you have to move. And this is also very important that you shall know all about your important pages which you have to read to the judge. Sometimes the judge is putting the questions and he wants to bring our attention on certain point, so we have to move towards that page and towards that particular point quickly. This is very important. Don't look here and there when you are standing in the court. Keep attention on your file. This is important. Then this is also important that when you are arguing your case at the appellate stage, so you should know that where is the operative para. Whenever the judge making a judgment, always he is making an operative para. Normally that para is para 34, which is very important and you have to read out that. And often the judges draw our attention to that para because that para is very important, in which the judge has made his own observation. So you have to read out that. Similarly, at appellate stage, this is also important that we should know that where I have placed the FIR, where I have placed the postmortem report, where I have placed the other important documents, you should know. And when the judge said to you, come to that point, so your fingers should go automatically to that points, to that place, to that page, and you have to answer accordingly what the judge asking from you. So this was about putting our case before the judge. Certain points which I would like to say regarding this, you have also to note that use very polite language, be decent, try to understand the judge's point of view, try to tolerate in the court. Whenever the judge raising the bad points of your case or flaws in your case, try to listen the judge attentively. This is also very important, and try to raise admissible points and admissible documents and admissible evidence in the court. Then the court will give you relief in your case. And whenever you are arguing your case, basically you are taking relief from the case. So for relief, this is important that we have to be egoless, we have to be very decent, and the manner in which we are speaking, it is must be clear and polite, and we have also to be very good listeners when we are presenting our case before the judge or judges in the court. So this was about how to present your case before the court. So we have discussed this. With this, I end my this lecture. Thank you.